Today I'm going to show you how to calibrate and bump test a GX3R in an SDM3R docking station. So turn the docking station on using the power button and lift the red lid. The SDM3R can calibrate a GX3R and a GX3R Pro. So to calibrate a GX3R, this lever needs to be up. If we were going to do a GX3R Pro, the lever would need to be down. So I'm going to put it back up, make sure it clicks all the way into place. Install your GX3R, push all the way down, and close the red lid. The instrument turns on automatically and connects to the SDM3R. These are the auto calibration values that we're going to be using for our calibration. They need to match the values listed on your calibration cylinder. If they don't match, you need to change the autocal values in the GX3R. So I have my calibration cylinder, a demand flow regulator, and my calibration tubing. I'm going to connect my cylinder to the gas 1 fitting on the side of the SDM3R. This is the air, gas 1, gas 2, gas 3. Gas 2 and 3 are only used for calibrating or bump testing a GX3R Pro. So I'm going to connect to gas 1. To start a calibration, push and hold cal. Air is flowing through the air fitting. If you do not have a fresh air environment, you need to connect a cylinder of zero air to your air fitting. But since we're in a fresh air environment here, I don't have a zero air cylinder connected. So now it's drawing through the gas 1 fitting. It's drawing through my cylinder. It's going to draw gas for 1 minute. You can see the readings starting to change. The length of a calibration is adjustable in the edit menu. And now it's flushing with air, just to make sure all of the calibration gas is out of the internal tubing of the SDM3R. Now it's doing an alarm check. That checks LED and buzzer functionality. So here's the results screen. You can see the calibration result, the calibration readings, and the LED buzzer result. Since everything passed, the instrument is going to turn off automatically, and you can remove it and use it. So now I'm going to show you how to do a bump test using the docking station. So if you had just put your instrument in, you close the lid, and it turns on, press and hold bump. It's flushing with fresh air. You can see this F down here in the lower right corner. That means the docking station is going to do a fast bump. It's going to apply calibration gas, and then it's going to let it sit there, and it's going to take the highest LEL, CO, and H2S reading and the lowest oxygen. And if those readings fall within the tolerance for the bump test, it will pass the bump test and move on. Using fast bump is a way to save calibration gas. So now we have calibration gas flowing. You can hear the pump running. And now you hear the pump stop. The gas is still sitting up against the GX3R, and you can see the readings are still changing. Now the SDM is flushing with fresh air to get all of that calibration gas out, doing an alarm check. And here are the bump test results. So these were the bump readings, the actual result, and then the LED and buzzer check results. Since everything was successful, the instrument will be shut off, and we can remove it. And that is how you calibrate and bump test a GX3R in an SDM3R docking station.